How's it going, everybody? Welcome to the first Ask Jesse. This is a new program we're rolling out for 2015, and how it's going to work is every Friday I will post a comment or a little post thingy, and it'll say put your questions or ask Jesse or something clever. I haven't figured out quite what it's going to look like yet. Maybe we'll even have a cool little picture. You guys will leave all your questions in the comments below, and then I'm going to pick one or two of them to answer every Monday, just like I am today. I hope you guys find a lot of value in this, and it's my way to try to continue to serve you the best I possibly can. So here we go. Let's cut right to it. Our first question comes to us, and you guys, you have to forgive my mispronunciation of any names in advance, because I've been known to mispronounce names. Okay, so our first question comes from Kathy Rustin of Tulsa, Oklahoma. And she says, I've been married for 13 years. I have so much resentment toward my husband for not holding a job and then eventually moving me away from my family. He has a job that he is fulfilled in and I'm happy for him, but how do I let go of the resentment and bad attitude toward him so we can enjoy each other again? There is a reason we married. I just can't remember. I'd like to find that again. He's a good man. Well, Kathy, this is a great question. First of all, thanks for asking it, putting yourself out there. And the key to it is just what you said. You have to look at him and see him for the reasons that you married and not for how you perceive him now for the one or two things. Because if we look at it this way, when we look at a person and we look at especially the spouse or somebody we love very much, odds are they've done hundreds if not thousands of little things and big things over the course of your lifetime together that have built that relationship, that have formed that bond that the two of you share. Yet when there's one or two things that happen that just take away from that, that kind of get under your skin or upset you or maybe piss you off or hurt your feelings, we tend to focus on those things and we start to see that person as those one or two things. And when we're seeing that person, what happens is it creates this tunnel vision and we're forgetting about all the wonderful things that they've done before. And so what we start to see when we see our persons, we don't even see our husband or our wife or our brother or sister or our boyfriend or girlfriend. Instead, we see the problem, or our perception of the problem, right? And that's not fair to either one of you. So what you have to do is you have to start first by seeing him for who he really is. And those are all the reasons why you guys came together in the first place. My suggestion to you is if you can't think of him off the top of your head, sit down with a pen and paper and write out every single thing that you love about your husband. Every single thing that you find funny about him. Every single thing you find attractive and sexy about him. Every single thing you like about him. Write down a list of as many things possible that you can think of that he's done for you in the past. All the times that he may have given you a surprise note or sent you a sweet text message or made a kind phone call. All those things that make him a good man, and list them out for yourself. You want to flood your mind with it so it's so present in your mind that's all you can see and focus on. And then every time you look at him, you're going to look at your list or remember a few things from your list and see, allow yourself to see only those things. It'll take some time, it'll take some practice, but I promise you that if you start implementing this right away, you will see a dramatic shift in how you perceive him. Okay, great question. Let's do one more. I hope you guys like this. This is kind of fun. I'm a little nervous. I've never done this before. This one is from Stephanie, is it Yoder or Yoder? Again, you guys apologize for the names. And this one says, this is something I've been dealing with for years, and I'm on the fence about what to do about it. What do you do when people continually try to make you feel like you aren't good enough? And suddenly they are family, but only through marriage. I know what I would like to do, but need someone's opinion that is outside the situation. So what Stephanie's asking is what can you do when people are continually trying to make you feel you aren't good enough? Here's my answer, Stephanie. The answer is first of all, nobody can make you feel that you aren't good enough. Only you can decide to feel that you're not good enough. People can say things, they can do things, and how we choose to interpret what they say, how we choose to perceive their actions, that's our decision. That's our decision, right? If somebody throws us an egg, and I don't know why this is popping in my head, but I'm just going with it. If somebody throws us an egg and it breaks and it falls on our hand, we can either blame them for throwing us a crackable egg that spills everywhere, or we can thank them and acknowledge them for their generous act of being willing to share an egg with us, right? So our perception and our interpretation of their behaviors, their actions, their words is up to us. Us deciding to feel bad is not because they're telling us to feel bad or saying or doing things to make us feel bad. We're deciding to feel bad. So what I would tell you is this. Only you can decide how you're going to feel. Only you can decide how you're going to feel. And if they're spending so much time, energy, if they're putting so much attention onto you, that must mean that you hold a pretty significant place in their heart and mind to do so. I would be willing to bet that what they express outwardly towards you is probably a mirror of some of their insecurities they have inside, and that they are just articulating it that way towards you. Something really powerful to remember is anytime there's a finger pointing at you, or pointing at you, somebody's pointing a finger at you, there's always three fingers pointing back at them. So typically, more often than not, our projections onto other people are usually our reflections of ourselves. Okay, I hope that helps. Awesome, you guys. There you go. Those are our questions for the week. I hope you guys will participate next week. I hope this has been of value to you. I hope this is something that you find that you can enjoy. And the questions we can ask are broad. You can ask questions like we asked today. You can ask personal questions. You can ask more broad questions. You can ask whatever you feel would give you the most value. And again, I'll pick them going forth. You guys, thank you so much for being here and watching this video. If you found value in this video, please share it with your friends and family. It helps me to get my message out. Also, if you wouldn't mind taking a second to click like and maybe even subscribe, it just helps the video to get more awareness on YouTube. You guys are amazing. Thank you again for all your ongoing support. From my heart, I appreciate it. I look forward to chatting with you all again next Monday. Talk to you then.